Chairman Gallagher and to our full committee chairman, Lamar Smith, I have always been proud of the fact that the House Judiciary Committee has always evaded the partisan tiffs that frequently characterize what goes on in the House of Representatives. And I regret that today we're confronted with a dilemma that I would like to address and see if we can somehow rebuild the goodwill that has always existed on this committee. Now, as I look across this audience, I would be pretty naive not to notice that there are many more women in this audience than are usually, that is usually the case. And I think it's because of the nature of the hearing that's going on today. I want to remind everybody, and with the permission of the chairman, I'd like to put into the record the New York Times editorial of today by this famous Haitian writer, Haitian-American writer, she has citizenship in both countries, Miss Edwidge Danticat, whose article is entitled "Detention is No Holiday."
Mr. Conyers, I assume you're referring to what was, I believe, to be an op-ed, not an editorial.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, it was an op-ed. It wasn't.
Okay, without objection.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. So here's the problem. And this is a sentence that comes out of the article that the op-ed that is going into the record by Ms. Danticat, whom I must confess I just talked to on the phone an hour ago to let her know that I had delivered a letter to our chairman, Lamar Smith, which I also asked unanimous consent to include in the record, please.
Without objection.
Thank you very much. I read just a sentence from Ms. Danticat. We are being too generous in deciding to give them safe water, an hour a day of recreation, and of off-site medical care if they are in danger of dying. And I think that's what it comes down to. And I conclude with this. I have the highest respect for the Director of U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement, John Morton, its director. I know of the good reputation of the Assistant Director, Kevin Landy, who is our lead-off witness today. And so I want us to balance what we say against what our ranking member, Zoe Lofgren of California, has recited about the kind of conditions that people are frequently forced to live in, and I hope that we can come to reasonable conclusions. And I thank the chairman for his time, and I yield back whatever is left.